Parashat Shlach, nothing but the truth. Emet, or truth, is one of the most important values in Judaism and in life. That's why it may surprise you to hear that Rabbi Eliyahu, the Gaon of Vilna, said that many people, when they say Shema, do not tell the Emet. But don't worry. What he meant was that they pronounce the word for truth as Emes, or Emet, instead of Emes, or Emet. They put the accent on the first syllable, which is called Mila'el, instead of on the last syllable, which is called Milara. It is extremely important to correctly pronounce the words of the Shema. The first rabbi of Chabad, Rabbi Shneur Zalman of Ladi, was only 13 years old when somebody asked him, what is the only pasuk in the Torah which starts and ends with the same three words? Without pausing, he replied, it was when Moshe Rabbeinu did not say the Emet. What, you are thinking? How could we even think that Moshe Rabbeinu would not tell the truth? Don't worry, this is what he meant. In Parashat Shelach, the last pasuk of Vayomer, which is the third paragraph of Kriyat Shema, is Ani Hashem Elokechem Asher Hotzeiti Etchem Me'eretz Mitzrayim Liyot Lachem Leilokim. Ani Hashem Elokechem. It starts with Ani Hashem Elokechem and it ends with Ani Hashem Elokechem. However, when we say this pasuk in our tefillah, we always add the word Emet. But it is not part of the pasuk itself. Moshe never said it in the Torah. That is how Moshe did not say the Emet. Emet is also a very important theme in the story of the spies, the Miraglim. The 10 evil spies who discouraged Bnei Yisrael from entering Eretz Yisrael totally misused the idea of truth. First, Rashi explains, they used a little bit of truth at the beginning of their words just so that Bnei Yisrael would believe their lies. They said that indeed the land of Israel was flowing with milk and honey, but then they added the word Ephes, which here means however, and began arguing against entering the land, saying that the people there were too strong and the land was too harsh. What could it be that made the Miraglim twist the Emet and discourage all of Bnei Yisrael? The Miraglim's idea of truth was limited to what they could see and touch. By that definition, no one can conquer the land of Israel. They forgot that for a Jew, the truth must always include Hashem's help and our belief and faith in Hashem. If you take Hashem away from the Emet, what you have left without Hashem is only sheker, lies, and falsehood. Even though he wasn't traditionally religious, the first prime minister of Israel, David Ben-Gurion, understood this idea when he said, in Israel, in order to be a realist is someone who looks at the world the way it actually is and is not overly optimistic, in order to be a realist, he said, you must believe in miracles. We believe that those miracles are because we add the Emet to our of Hashem to our concept of Emet. At SAR, we feel that all of our lives and all of our goals must include Hashem and His help. We set our goals very high, and we trust that Hashem will help us to achieve them. And He always has.